My name is Kuniharu Takei. I'm from the Osaka Prefecture University, Japan. So today I'm going to talk about our recent research progress, especially about the printed nanomaterial-based flexible device such as the sensor and the transistors. So if we can realize the large scale and the flexible and ultra weight the sensors that can conformally cover any surfaces, that there are a lot of applications such as the flexible the health monitoring and human interface like a poster, and also robotics applications. In addition to this kind of the human interactive devices, there are also the industry application, as you can see these pictures. To realize this kind of the flexible devices, so the key technology is how to form the active material on the flexible substrates. So to address this challenge, so we have developed the four types of printing technique on a flexible substrate using especially inorganic nanomaterial instead of the organic material. So since the time is very limited, so I cannot talk about the details. But anyway, so the first technique is nanowire printing using the semiconductor material such as these materials onto any substrate by modifying the surface. The second technique is the two-dimensional ultra-thin film transfer technique. And third one is the carbon nanotube, the solution-based printing techniques. So in addition to these techniques, so to move forward to realizing the macro scale and practical applications, we also developed the screen printing techniques, as you can see these pictures. So basically, so after printing the film onto the flexible substrate, we utilize the film for the sensor and the transistors. And then, so using that the film, so we are working on the different types of application, as you can see these pictures. However, today I want to focus on the only one the application that is robotics. So especially for our device, the sensor is very ultra weight and also the high sensitivity. So that one of the application is for the micro or mini robot that is made of the paper or plastic substrates, as you can see this here, these pictures. So this robot is made of the paper, basically. However, unfortunately, micro or mini robot doesn't have enough power to move with the conventional sensors because the conventional sensor is very heavy for this robot. On the other hand, although this robot doesn't have enough power to move with the sensors, the robot still needs to sense a lot of the information, such as to distinguish whether it can go forward or not between the object like a cat or the animal. So to give the robot the function to sense the different type of things, so we propose to integrate the animal whisker. That's why we call the artificial electronic whisker or e-whiskers. So the animal whisker can detect the spatial distribution by touching the object and also the detect the wind flow. In addition to that, so basically the animal whisker is based on the skin. The skin can detect the temperature. That's why, so if we can realize this kind of the sensitivity, that it might be useful for the robotic applications. So to address that, so we have developed the strain sensor material onto the flexible substrate. The material is pretty simple. So we have a silver nanoparticle and carbon nanotube and polymer materials. And then we measure the electrical resistance. So the mechanism is quite simple. So basically, so we measure the electrical resistance, and when you apply the tensile strain or bend the substrate downward like this, then the silver nanoparticle distance is increased. That means the electrical resistance is increased. By measuring this, the resistance change, so we can detect the strain value. And then so here, so by after developing the ink, so we are we fabricate the strain sensors. The process is also simple. Here we use the screen printing techniques. So after we make carbon nanotube and silver nanoparticle inks, and then we design the mask for the screen printing, and we just put the ink onto over the mask, and then we printed the film onto the flexible substrate, and then we cure the ink at 70 degrees C. And then we cut the plastic substrate using laser cutter tool to make some kind of the whisker structures. And if you look at the cross-sectional SEM of the printed film, so we have mainly the silver nanoparticle ink, silver nanoparticles, and then the carbon nanotube is surrounding the silver nanoparticles. Again, so here for the strain sensor, we use a mixture of the carbon nanotube and silver nanoparticle inks. And then so since here, so this is electronics device and fabrication technique, so we can also integrate the other sensor. So here, as I mentioned before, we also integrate the temperature sensor onto the flexible substrate with the strain sensors. So for the temperature sensor, we use a mixture of the carbon nanotube and P.PSS, the conductive polymer inks. And then we also fabricate we also print and pattern the device, something like this. And then so by optimizing the surface condition of the flexible substrate, so we can print print the sensor on any substrate such as polyethylene, PET, and silicon rubber. And also, of course, we can print on a glass or silicon substrate. And then so since we measure the resistance change of the sensor, so we just set a very simple the measurement setup to measure the resistance change. And then first we characterize the strain sensor. So again, we use the mixture of the carbon nanotube ink and silver nanoparticle inks. So this graph shows the resistance change as a function of the applied pressure or displacement of the substrate. And then here basically so we found that by changing the mixture ratio of the inks, we can easily tune the sensitivity of the sensors. So if you look at some point here, the resistance change is different at the different composition of the ink. So that means we can really, apply the sensor depending on the application, how high sensitivity is required, without changing the design. That means process itself and the device is pretty low cost, since we don't need to redesign the mask. And also, as we expected, when we apply the compressive strain, the resistance is decreased, and when we apply tensile strain, the resistance is increased. And by optimizing the condition of the printing technique, so we could achieve the pretty high the strain sensitivity with this structure that is around 59% per Pascal. And also here, so as I mentioned before, so we also integrate the temperature sensor. We also study the temperature dependence of the temperature sensors. If you this graph shows the resistance change ratio as a function of temperatures. So here, for the temperature sensor, so the mechanism is to measure the electron hopping probability when you change the temperatures. So that when temperature is increased, that resistance decreases. That is shown here with the red circle dots for the temperature sensors. And based on the linear fitting of the graph, so we could the temperature sensitivity is around 0.6% per degree C. And also, since here we integrate the strain sensor together to monitor the temperature and the strain distributions, we also measure the temperature dependence of the strain sensor, as you can see the blue square dots here. Based on this, the strain sensor doesn't have a huge sensitivity for the temperatures. In addition, we also study the strain dependence for the temperature sensor. As you can see in the red circle dot here. And based on this, the temperature sensor doesn't have a huge dependence of the strain. That means the strain and temperature sensor we developed here has a high selectivity between strain and temperature. That means we can measure the each stimulus precisely, even if we integrate these sensors together. And then so first, we make some kind of the whisker array, nine arrays, as a first proof of concept. And then we just scan some kind of object. Here we use the initial of our university, Osaka Prefecture Universities. And then so we scan our e-whisker over this object. And then we can map out get some electrical result. As you can see, this is the image. And also by making the step-like structure like this, so we can also get some height information from our e-whisker with the resolution of 100 micrometer in these structures. And then so now, so we also try to integrate the temperature and the strain sensors. To be simplified, we just laminate the two sensors together. And then we scan the warmed copper object, as you can see these pictures. And then we can get some kind of the shape distribution and also temperature distribution using these devices. So and then so next step in the future work, as a future work, next step is should be integrated to the robot, and we need to study the interface between the device and the micro robot. Anyway, so here, so since we developed the strain and temperature sensors, we can also apply that sensor to the another techniques. The next target is to develop the artificial electronic the skin. So the reason why we are working on the e-skin is because the none of them has been realized to imitate the fully function of the human skin. Our human skin can detect the tactile and the friction and the temperatures. However, most of the report for the e-skin can detect only tactile and temperature, but the friction force information is pretty important to imitate the human skin for the robot applications. But since time is very limited, I cannot talk about the detail, but we have some kind of the three-dimensional structure here to create the strain distribution when you apply the tactile and the friction force. And then so we have also four the strain sensors, so the strain sensor can detect the strain distributions. And also we have a temperature sensor on the pixel. And again, so this sensor is fabricated by the only the screen printing technique. And then, so I need to skip here. But anyway, so we can detect the tactile and the friction and the temperature distribution on our e-skin devices. And then so next step, so here, so we only develop the sensors. However, to realize the practical application, we also need to integrate the signal processing circuit in addition to the sensors. So we are also working on the flexible circuit. So here, so we integrate some kind of CMOS digital circuit using inorganic materials. In addition, to realize the high integration, we also integrate each device and transistor and sensor on the lateral side and also vertical side. So for example, in this study, we fabricate N-type transistor on the first layer using indium gallium zinc oxide. And on the second layer, we integrate a P-type transistor using carbon nanotube. And then on the third layer, we integrate the temperature sensors. And then after fabrication, so we could make this kind of the flexible device. And also we can bend the substrate without having any cracking or delamination of the devices or materials. And then here is the electrical characteristics. I'm not sure you are familiar with this the performance, but anyway, so we could achieve the relatively high on-off ratio of P-type and N-type transistors with pretty high mobility, roughly 5 square centimeters per volt second on flexible substrate. And then we also integrate the P-type and N-type transistor to make a CMOS gate CMOS inverter that is shown here. And the voltage gain is around 50, and the power consumption is around less than 7 nanowatt per millimeter normalized with the channel width of transistors. And also, this is the flexible devices. So we also characterize the mechanical flexibility and reliability of the device by bending the substrate up to 2.6 millimeter. And based on this, so the transistor doesn't show any huge the change by bending the substrate. And also by bending the substrate up to 1,000 cycles, the transistor is still stable and the mechanically reliable. And then we also integrate the temperature on the third layer, so we also check that the sensor is working well. And then finally, so here we just integrate only the two transistors, but to move forward to realizing the next step, to realize the signal processing circuit, we also need to integrate more the transistors. So as a proof, the first step, so we just make a CMOS NAND and a NOR circuit. as you can see these pictures, and then we confirm that so the transistors can operate on a flexible substrate at the flat state well. And also by bending the substrate, so by bending substrate at the 2.6 millimeter curvature radius, the still the NAND and NOR circuit operate well without malfunctions. That means our flexible flexible transistor platform can be mechanically flexible and reliable. So now, we develop the sensors and transistor on a flexible substrate to realize this kind of health monitoring or some kind of the practical application. We are now trying to integrate the component on a flexible substrate to realize the system level. And then, so this is acknowledgement, and thank you for your attention.